Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how you can connect your email domain to Microsoft Outlook. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. But to get started with the guide, if you want to add an email address to Outlook and that email address is hosted on a custom domain, meaning it's not one of the popular providers like Outlook or Gmail or Yahoo or any other, and it's a custom email domain hosted by a third party. The best way that I've found to do this is by actually minimizing or closing Outlook, then doing a search for the control panel, and then launching the control panel. And then inside the control panel, just make sure you change this to small or large icons. You want to find Mail, the Microsoft Outlook Mail option here, and then click on that. Next, you want to click on Email Accounts. And then in this window, you want to click on New. That's going to bring up this window. And here you need to select Manual Setup or Additional Server Types, then click on Next. Then choose POP or IMAP, and then click on Next. Now, very important, you'll need to have the correct email address, password, server settings, and port settings before you can set this up. So you'll need to get that from your email provider. I'm going to set up one of my custom domains email addresses right here. So I'll just go ahead and do that. In your name, you can obviously just add your name. And in email address, add your email address. In the account type, you need to choose between POP3 and IMAP. Here, I suggest speaking to your email provider or the host of your domain so they can tell you what they suggest you use here. But basically, POP3 will download offline messages and save them to your computer, whereas IMAP is basically just a sync between Outlook on your computer and the emails on your server. For this example, I'm going to leave it on POP3, and then I'll enter the incoming mail server for my custom domain, and I'll also add the outgoing mail server or the SMTP server. And again, this is details that you need to get from your email host. Now, the username here for the logon information should be your full email address. And then you'll need to enter your password. Next, you can click on More Settings. Then you can click on Outgoing Server. And most of the time, you'll have to check this option that says your outgoing server requires authentication. But this is another setting that you have to check with your email host. For my email host, I have to have it turned on. Then click on Advanced. And then you need to make sure that your ports are correct. And again, you'll get this port from your email service provider. I'm going to change it to what my email service provider recommends. And then lastly, here in the delivery tab, if you have POP3 selected, you can choose to leave a copy of messages on the server and they'll remove it from the server after a certain amount of days. I'm just going to change this to 7 days. And then you can also check this option that says remove from server when deleted from deleted items. Meaning if you delete it from the deleted items in Outlook on your computer, it'll also be deleted from the server. So I'll click on OK. And then once you're ready to continue, you can click on Next. And it's going to do a test to see if you can download emails and if you can send emails by sending a test email message. And then once that's finished, you can click on Close. And then you can make sure that this checkbox is unchecked and then click on Finish. And if you go ahead and then open Outlook, you should have your custom email added into Outlook and see the inbox and any messages that'll download there. I hope this guide's been useful. Please like the video and I'll see you in the next one.